concepts in hydraulic and pneumatics that you'll be needing to understand the next 2-3 modules of my video. So let's get started. As you can see, this is a valve, the most basic component in a hydraulic system, and this is another valve, but they go by the different names. As you can see, 4x3 normally close DCV and 4x2 normally open DCV. DCV stands for direction control valve, as you can guess. 4x3, let me explain what this 4x3 and 4x2 means. 4 generally means the number of ports, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And 3 stands for the number of positions that your valve is going to act in, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Generally, these square blocks you can see is what you can call as the position of your valve. 2 here, so 4x2, 3 here, so 4x3. So you'll be wondering, what does this mean, normally closed and normally open? So basically, normally closed, as the name suggests, it means that these are closed, these ports are closed. Here, normally open means these ports are open. Normally closed, no matter how much, okay, the software is telling me to put a source here, I'll be doing that later. So if you apply any pressure, obviously under the strength of this valve, that how much it can bear, if you apply any bar, any pressure, it will not let the fluid pass from here to here. And basically, this is the central position, normally closed central position in this 4x3 DCV. But here, normally open, which suggests no matter how less you apply, the fluid will flow from this direction freely. So normally open, generally the port is open, normally closed, this position, in the central position, it is closed. So no fluid will pass from this side to this side. But if you want to move from this side to this side, that let me take this as the source side and this is the reservoir side, you can attach these two. And that will give us the tandem condition, tandem center to be precise. So that's it. Let's move on. Hey everybody, how's it going? Welcome back. As in my first video, I explained you about a 4x3 normally closed and a 4x2 normally open direction control valve. So enough with the basics. We'll be jumping right into the application. It's a hydraulic circuit containing different components and the nomenclature aside them. So let's start with the application. What our application is? Our application is to lower down a heavy weight. A weight in tons controlled in a controlled manner so that the gravity does not take control over the system and ruptures the whole system. As the load is acting downwards and the pressurized fluid will be acting in the blank end of the piston, which will give force in the downward direction also. So to come with that, we have provided a counterbalance valve which contains a check valve and a pressure relief system. This pressure gets cracked at, let me show you, 70 bar. At 70 bar, when the pressure reaches in this line 70 bar, this will crack, this will open it, and this line will get connected directly to the atmospheric reservoir. So let's start the simulation and let me take this picture out of the system. It's not a part of the system. Okay, so here the simulation. The pump is on. The blue line shows there is nothing going on as these two are connected. So pump flow goes from here to here to here. Okay, so let me explain what this pressure relief valve does. A pressure relief valve, what it does, it directs the fluid pressure coming from the pump in two directions. You can say X plus Y. X is the main 80% of the pressure that is going to drive the circuit, and 20% will be directed to the reservoir so that if any emergency situation or any problem occurs in the circuit, it should not destroy the components. So if I need to lower down the weight, I'll be switching to this position number one. you can see the red line shows the high pressure line. It goes down. It is going down really slow as it's a slow motion. And as soon as it touches it, the flow here gets stripped because the pressure relief valve was cracked at 70 bar. And is it 70? No, it's 68.55. So it's not cracked, it's closed. So the all fluid which was here is now extracted to the atmosphere. But the amazing thing is pump is really working hard. It's producing around 360 or 300 plus bar, which is really disastrous. So we need to divert it through the pressure relief valve, which is cracking at 290 bar, to the reservoir. Now, if I have to move up the load, pick the load from this position to that position, a little above position, so I'll be choosing this second position. Now the pressure gets directed to this line. Red line shows the high pressure line. Now the amazing thing is the pressure will be directed through the check valve, as this provides the least resistance, as this line provides the more resistance as compared to the check valve. So it will go from here to here, as you can see it was working, to here, to the rod side of the piston, and it will lift the whole assembly up. And here, without any restriction, the fluid will be passed on to the reservoir. Again, the pressure relief valve gets cracked at 290 bar as soon as it hits the top dead center. So the pressure relief valve relieves the pressure. So even if the pump is working, it is safe. The circuit is safe. So let's take it in a fast motion. Just look the speed of the extension again. Look at the speed. It is controlled. You may think that how am I saying it's controlled? You'll see right now. If I take the second position, the retraction speed is double of that. Let me take it this again. This second position, it goes way too fast. So on taking the load up, it's not a big deal, but when it's going down, the gravity acts in the downward direction and the system may get destructed. So this was the first application of a 4x3 open ripe DCV. So hang around, I'll be catching you with you guys later. Welcome back again. Last but not the least, a sequencing hydraulic circuit. This circuit requires a sequence valve which will sequence the motion of the actuators included. It's a drilling application which requires the clamping of the workpiece first and then drilling into the job. For that, the clamping actuator must extend fully, then drilling actuator in that sequence. So the components are a pump, reservoir, pressure relief valve, push button actuated 4x3 normally closed spring return DCV, two sequence valves with check valves included, four analog pressure gauges, two double acting hydraulic cylinders. So let's get started with the simulation. Okay. So in position 1, from the pump through the DCV, the flow goes to the line A, to the blank side of the clamping cylinder. As soon as it extends fully, the pressure rises up in the A line, and if it gets above the cracking pressure of the sequence valve, the sequence valve will let the fluid flow in this direction to the blank end side of the drilling operation cylinder, which will drill into the jaw. Then through the sequence valve 2, it goes to the blank end side and the fluid exits from the line B to the reservoir directly. But in clamping cylinder, the fluid from the rod end side exits through the check valve as it provides the least resistance of these two paths. Now, in position 3, the DCV or the source will provide the flow through the B line to the rod end side of the drilling cylinder. It will move the drill up, then the exiting fluid will go through this sequence valve circuit, but it will not pass through the sequence valve line, it will pass through the check valve, as the least resistance is provided by the check valve to this flow. It flows directly into the reservoir. And as drilling gets retracted fully, the pressure rises in this line, the sequence valve gets cracked above the cracking pressure, it lets the fluid flow through here, to here, to here. So it will also retract the clamping cylinder and the exit fluid will go from the line A directly to the reservoir. So let us see the simulation now. Extension stroke, clamping, and then after drilling. After it, if we want to take the workpiece out of it, drill bit gets out and then the clamping goes out. So this was about how can you drill. So I collapse, I'm spilling these raps long as you feel them. To the day that I drop, you'll never say that I'm not killing them. Cause when I am not, then I'ma stop pinning them. And I am not hip hop, and I'm just not Eminem. Subliminal thoughts when I'ma stop sending them. Women are caught in webs, spin them in heart venom. Adrenaline shots, the penicillin could not get the illin to stop. Amoxicillin's just not real enough. The criminal cop killing hip hop, filling a minimal swap to cop millions of pop listeners. You're coming with me, feel it or not. You're gonna fear it like I showed you. The spirit of God lives in us. You hear it a lot, lyrics the shock. Is it a miracle or am I just product of pop? Listen up, the sizzle, my whistle, this is the plot. Listen up, you glizzles for God, slizzle does not give a fuck.
Till the room comes off, till the lights go out, till my leg give out, can't shut my mouth. Till the smoke clears out, and my eyes burn out, I'ma rip this shit till my bone pull out.